What's up guys, welcome to YouTube. So guys, I'm going to be making the review about the M21. So yeah, now the new update came that the One UI 2.1, that was the new update for the Samsung Galaxy M21, that's the One UI core version of 2.1. So as you can see, now I have made in my previous video, I've given an intro about what features will come with the One UI 2.1, but I'm going to be now reviewing it, and then after the videos I'm going to be telling about the pros and the cons, and then at the last I'm going to be talking about some confusion I've seen. So I was searching about this phone only for the updates, and some people are having confusion that it will receive Android 11 later on or later Androids also. So I will talk about it in the video. So see the video till end. So let me show you some features of 22.1. So you can see, so it's running the One UI 2.1 version, that's the core version. Now, so first change. Now, this format. Now, you will get the new animation for changing the dark mode. So the first, now the One UI 2.0, so it didn't have this animation thing type of thing. So we get option like the adaptive brightness that for the dark mode. Now we can see you can switch easily to animation. That's the new feature. That's the new small feature. And the second feature is on also a quick share. Samsung has added their own quick share for sharing. Now you can share from Bluetooth and it is fast from the normal Bluetooth sharing. Now the third thing, they've added the live captions. If you're watching some video and there's no captions in the video and all, and you want captions, so you can turn on the video and the phone will auto generate the captions in the video. And let me talk about the other things. Now the main improvements are in the camera only. Now the camera, let me show you the change in the camera. The main improvements are in the camera. As you can see, we get the single take mode, single take option in here, and we get the night hyperlapse. As you can see, so that's the new options, and we get the 10x hybrid zoom. Let me show you. Sorry, hybrid zoom. I'm telling you about hybrid zoom. So one minute. I want to switch to the. So this is the, now this is the 10x digital zoom. Now first, in the One UI 2.1, we only get the 4x option, the digital zoom. But now, right now, we get the 10x zoom, and that's great. Now the camera has been improved a lot in the terms, as you can see, it's a 48 megapixel shot, as you can see. So yeah, you can see the 48 megapixel shots, and so yeah, it is clear and all. And in situations, yeah, it's great. Now the pictures, the qualities are great, and we get the single take mode option. Now the single take, as you know, the new phones, we get the, it will, in one shot it will create 10 photos. That's, now let me talk about the basic performance improvements. Yeah, now we have seen the improvement in the UI, and so they have fixed some bugs and all, but yeah, the UI has become fast and it's looking more convenient, and it has become fast, and the rebooting speed is also from fast. But I was having some problems with the camera only, and that was a problem for me also in One UI 2.1. So when you're switching to the 48 megapixel high resolution shot, so it will take time. So it will take a lot of time to saving and all, and yeah, I've seen. So yeah, Samsung needs to fix this feature. Now let me talk about the basic and the battery stuff. Now the battery life has been great, so you can see. So yeah, when I charge to 100%, so yeah, it will work. It was showing to one day me five hours. So in somewhat in the previous version, I was having some problems with the battery. So the battery draining issue was having. The battery draining issue, like, it was only working like 7 hours, and it was like battery was draining to 15%. So yeah, now once I was having a lot of problems, so I contacted to Samsung, and so they have done. So yeah, So from the help of smart tutor, so they have just disabled that, as you can see. So they have put in the put app to sleep and they have put the options to the optimized mode. So yeah, but I was not seeing the the battery improvements was not that great after all the putting that settings. But now right now the battery is great. It is working. It is giving me output of 110 hours. And the biggest change in the battery, the biggest change is the charging speed. Now this phone comes with a 6000 mAh battery and the charger is only for 15W fast charger. But right now, so in the previous version it will take 2 hours and 45 minutes and 3 hours. Even sometimes I was irritated, it will take 4 hours to charge sometimes. And right now the charging speed has improved. Now like I've put it in 7 o'clock and it will exactly charge in 2 hours and 9 a.m. it will just charge 100%. So yeah, and 45 minutes has been reduced from the previous version. So yeah, regarding the battery right now, some people are having problems with this version. Now I cannot see that some people are having problem with charging, but my charging speed has become fast. And I think the phone is looking great and it's working great. Now the meanwhile, now the gaming experience. So yeah, so a lot of you guys are gamers and play games, and for the gaming performance I didn't like it. I'm not appreciated from this OneUI 2.1 because now in the previous version the games were like running really great without the gaming launcher. So I had disabled the gaming launcher earlier, but now after putting the gaming launcher, so yeah, now in this update when I updated, so I was playing a game and the game was getting so heated. After 10-15 minutes you'll see the problem like thermal throttling. So yeah, when I enable the gaming launcher and after the gaming launcher, the game performance become better. But you can see right now from the gaming poster, now the gaming problem is solved from that. Now let me tell you about the cons for the gaming and for the software and the UI. This update and like the features are in the pro section. The cons section are the gaming speed and some of the bugs like the navigation and bugs. I am saying that the charging is now also poor in this device right now, because in 2 hours the 6000 mAh battery with a 15W fast charger is great. And now the camera, selfie camera, has been improved a lot. Now I will give you the samples in the end of the video. Now let me talk about it will receive the OneUI 3. So people are having, so yeah, as I have told you, I was searching and some queries were mine that it will come with the OneUI 2.5 or it will come with the OneUI 3 core version or not. So yeah. Now Samsung, on the other hand, they have promised that they will be giving in the A series and the S series, they will be receiving 3 years of updates. But the M series will receive their 2 years of updates. That was the old version, like it will receive. So yeah, so it's gonna be receiving the Android 11. Now it's my thinking that it will not receive any OneUI Core 2.5 version. Now after 2 months there will be another security patch update or what, and it will directly now receive to the OneUI 3. Because yeah, now it's my thinking, now it can be possible that next update would be the OneUI 2.5 update. But yeah, it's OneUI 3 and it will receive the OneUI 3. And so yeah, the 2 years update, so yeah, it will go with the Android 11 and Android 12. So yeah, it will receive 2 updates from the device. Now but as it is a budget phone, and you guys will be thinking that now Samsung will be providing the Android 11 also in this. No, it will receive the 2 years of update. Now the A series and the SE smartphones are receiving 3 updates. Now but in my like, now as the OneUI 2.14, so yeah, it will receive the OneUI 3.0 OneUI 3.0 in January, I think. So in January 2021 or February 2021 it will receive the Android 11 update. Yeah, now No, as I have the S20, so the S20 will receive the update earlier. So yeah, if the update comes, I will make a review surely. And so I'm gonna be making now the S20 at the other end is running on One UI 2.5. So yeah, I will make the video of that. Now, in my final opinion, the One UI 2.1 is great, but yeah, it needs some optimization, and for gaming also, we are seeing the thermal throttling problem. So yeah, now it is having the Exynos 9611, yeah. So somewhat Exynos processors are somewhat in gaming, yeah, it heats much. Gaming, it's not made for that gaming, you can do gaming, but the Exynos processors are not that great for optimization in gaming. But yeah, you can do really good gaming. So yeah, it needs some bug fixes and some optimization, the phone will work great. And I am saying that, you know, the phone is come great with the single take, that option now we were seeing in the M51, M31S or the A71 and all, and you were seeing in S series also. So yeah, now this is good, but and this update would be same also received in the M31. I don't know what changes they have done, this update is similar, but in my thinking that the update will be similar. And so yeah, I was seeing that the thermal throttling problem in this device. So yeah, now it's my thought for the it will receive the One UI 3, it will not receive the One UI 2.5. But yeah, also so yeah, it's my thinking. So yeah, it can receive, and at the last I would say that One UI 2.1 is great, but yeah, it needs some optimization and the bug fixes. Now the pros are these features only, the camera features and the quick share and all. And even the charging right now, charging speed has also increased. And the cons, I would think that the gaming optimization and all, and the selfie camera has been improved. Now the One UI, so yeah, now it will receive the Android 11, I think so, in January 2021 or the February 2021. And yeah, I have the S20, so the S20 will come, obviously the update will come earlier, so I will make the video. And S20 is now running on One UI 2.1, so I 2.5, so I'm gonna be making in the next video. So thank you guys, and like my video, subscribe my channel.